We're obviously at a time when it's an extremely dangerous situation between Iran and the United States and for the entire Middle Eastern region. You have said that Iran will retaliate for the targeted killing of General Qasem Soleimani. President Trump has said there would be a disproportionate response if you do that. What do you make of President Trump's threats?
Well, I think President Trump, after watching the crowd yesterday, must stop threatening. These people will be further enraged by his threats, and his threats will not frighten us. But what he's showing something. He's showing to the international community that he has no respect for international law, that he is prepared to commit war crimes, because attacking cultural sites is a war crime. In this disproportionate response is a war crime. Proportionality is a major principle of international law. But he doesn't care, it seems, about international law. But has he made U.S. more secure? Do Americans feel more secure? Are Americans welcome today in this region? Do they feel welcome? How do they feel about people chanting in the streets of Iraq, in the streets of Moscow, in the streets of Delhi, and everywhere else that they should leave? How do they feel about that? That's the price for arrogance, for ignorance, for lack of respect.
But President Trump was saying, and Michael Pompeo was saying as well, that they have intelligence that General Soleimani was planning attacks, imminent attacks, on U.S. targets. They say this was a deterrent attack, and they do say that America is safer today.
Well, they're either based on misinformation or they're lying. Because General Soleimani's mission was to contain the anger in Iraq following the United States' murder of about 25 Iraqis. This is a very clear information that we had, clear information that the Iraqi government had. The government of Iraq has been on the record saying what he was doing. General Soleimani was the greatest force for stability in Iraq. He was the hero of the fight against Daesh, along with his companions, particularly Abu Mehdi al-Muhandis. They're revered by the people of Iraq. Did you see the funeral processions? Now, Mike Pompeo might like a video clip that somebody sent him showing a couple of people, 20 people, celebrating. But did he close his eyes to see the huge sea of people mourning in Iraq and in Iran? Their days in our region are numbered. Not because anybody will take any action against them, but because they are not welcomed in our region.
Your government and your leadership and the military here has vowed to take action against the United States.
Well,
what kind of retaliation is that going to be?
The United States violated three principles: Iraqi sovereignty and the agreement that they had with Iraq. They got a response from the Iraqi parliament. They violated the emotions of the people. They will get a response from the people. They killed one of our most revered commanders and most senior commanders, and they took responsibility for it. This is state terrorism. This is an act of aggression against Iran, and it amounts to an armed attack against Iran, and we will respond. But we will respond proportionately, not disproportionately, because we are committed to law. We are law-abiding people. We're not lawless like President Trump.
But how can you respond? Because the U.S. is already pulling additional troops into the Middle Eastern region, and they're saying that they're hardening the defenses of their bases that they have in this region as well.
Well, the United States has been in this region for many years and has not brought itself or the region any security. We leave it at that.
So you think that you can strike at any point?
Well, we think,
because you obviously, it's no secret that you control militias in this region, that you have forces that are on your side in this region, in many countries.
No, we have people on our side in this region. That's much more important. The United States believes that this beautiful military equipment, according to President Trump, that you spend $2 trillion on these beautiful military equipment. Beautiful military equipment don't rule the world. People rule the world. People. the United States has to wake up to the reality that the people of this region are enraged, that the people of this region want the United States out, and the United States cannot stay in this region with the people of the region not wanting it anymore.
But the United States and the Trump administration are saying that before the strike on General Soleimani, there were provocations by Iran and forces controlled by Iran. There were bases that were rocketed. There was obviously an American contractor who was killed. And then there was the protests at the embassy, which destroyed the outside of the embassy and laid the embassy under siege.
Well, the Iranian consulate in Najaf was burned. Did we take action against anybody? The United States has to realize that people in Iraq are angry, and they take their anger. Of course, they're more angry about the United States than anybody else. But what is important is for the United States to realize, for the Trump regime to realize, that everything in this region was improving. Following the JCPOA, we were having a normal elections in Iraq, normal elections in Lebanon, governments coming to office through the democratic process, negotiations started in Syria, we had the reducing of tension in Syria, government was established in Lebanon, government was established in Iraq. What happened? The United States started a maximum pressure campaign, terrorizing Iranian people, making it difficult for Iranians to even get food and medicine from outside. So a war started long time ago by the United States. The United States destroyed stability in this region. The United States undermined security in this region. So one contractor, at least in the last month, 25 Iranian babies died because of EB and because of US sanctions.
And that's all terrible, of course, that things like that are happening. But right now, isn't there a threat that all of this could descend into something much, much worse?
No.
You're saying you'll retaliate. They'll say they retaliate. Isn't there the risk of an all-out war that could destroy large parts of your country and the Middle East?
We are sitting at our home. We will defend our own territory. We will defend our people. The United States can defend the United States. But the United States cannot even claim to be defending the United States 7,000 miles away from home. We are here. We will not move. We've been here for 7 millennia. We will continue to be here. The United States is a newcomer.
Do you think it's even worth speaking to President Trump, or would it be worth speaking to him?
Well, he doesn't need speaking. He has to realize that he has been fed misinformation, and he needs to wake up and apologize. He has to apologize. He has to change course. He cannot add mistake upon another mistake. He is just making it worse for America. He is destroying the U.S. Constitution. He is destroying the U.S. political process. He is destroying the rule of law in the United States. But that's not for me to say. That's a domestic affair of the United States. He has enraged the people of our region. He has killed people of this region. He has spent $1 trillion. He said that the U.S. had wasted $7 trillion in our region. He has added another trillion. Is the United States more secure today because of that?